But again, good morning, and this morning we're going to focus on developing skills and as far as to become a rainmaker, and also look at, hey, how do I find a rainmaker for my organization? I'm going to share some insights relative to the skills and traits, and then how to develop a template for hiring a rainmaker. You know, it's no simple task. So the first thing, we got to understand what we're looking for. What are the attributes that make up a rainmaker? Now, there are many processes out there that should be used and can be used, and I think you'll hear a number of those today. But I'm going to focus and keep it basic, looking on how to identify these particular attributes in each step of recruiting and hiring. Now, I don't know if any of you have Googled Rainmaker, but there's just tons of information. All kinds of traits, personalities, characteristics. I've actually picked 8 particular traits that we'll look at, and I think there's lots of good information out there that these are pretty much pointing in that direction. First of all, a positive personality and perspective. Top producers are optimistic. They have attitudes and outlook of opportunity, not limitation. Second is passion. They're passionate about what they do. I guess the saying, if you can conceive it and believe it, you can achieve it. And that's pretty much the way you'll see them, a rainmaker generally feels about themselves. They're focused. Top producers are focused, and they're conscious of how they use their time. They focus on revenue, boosting activities and behaviors. They know the difference between pay time and no pay time. They know the difference between pay activities and no pay activities. They're organized. Top producers are obsessed with time management. Getting first things first and continuously seeking systems and processes to be more effective and efficient, really in all aspects of. They're goal and outcome oriented. High producers set goals supported by action plans that are detailed down to behaviors, the activities and behaviors. And then they track them. They hold themselves accountable to what's working and what's not working. They have a bias for action. Rainmakers are proactive. And they consistently monitor themselves relative to that. Tom Peter said in Search of Excellence, ready, fire, aim. Okay? Not ready, aim, fire. Ready, fire, aim. That's typically the rainmaker. They're sociable. They're sociable people. They, top producers proactively and energetically meet people to develop strong relationships with others. And then they're trustworthy. They make people feel comfortable. They generally are empathetic. They're good listeners. They're active listeners. And they're good at adjusting their communication style to get people confident and comfortable. Okay, I got the signal here. There's a handout in there that actually is a hiring template. Now, what you got is primary function identity. Well, first of all, team matrix at the bottom. And you'll notice at the very bottom of the page, got the traits, flip it over. There you go. The triangle, there's two sides. The triangle, primary, the team matrix is how will this individual fit in your team? What's the makeup of your team now? How will they fit in your team and your culture? Primary function identifiers are really the key. This is where we really work hard with folks when we work with our clients as far as what does this person need to be able to be successful? So what are the functions they're going to do? Are they going to prospect? Are they going to be good relationship builders? So on and so forth. Now, I think we've covered the winner's attributes pretty much with the traits and so forth that we listed. Okay. Turn it over to this side. This is an exercise search. This is where we really roll up our sleeves and look at what skills are needed, what experience, and so forth and so on. So if you got questions on any of this, this is a broad, this is